from his 26 years of less than traditional stand-up shows.
It's not abuse, it's tradition.
To his foray into Fitzbo.
Well, I'd certainly feel some pressure on the stretch.
Gareth Reynolds is a comedian who can do it all.
Now this time I'll use half my strength.
He hosts two wildly successful podcasts.
Oh my God.
The Dollop, which boasts more than 5 million monthly streams.
You're welcome.
And We're Here to Help with his good pal, Jake Johnson.
America's favourite podcast, Jake.
You can't
we're
say that, Gareth.
Plus he's even scored himself a writing credit on Arrested Development.
Why do we have to have a party every time someone in this family is released from prison?
You see the fun we have?
Now Gareth is back in town and taking the stage with a stand-up show that promises to be legendary.
Showtime.
Yeah, I think I'm going to leave soon.
Please welcome Gareth Reynolds!
Welcome to the show. Welcome to Australia.
Gareth,
it feels very American. We wouldn't call someone Gareth here. We'd be like, we might go Gary or Gazza. So maybe we could rename you Gazza for the rest of the interview.
That's fine. Yeah, Gareth, I mean, I've done pretty poorly with Gareth, so I'd love to try.
Doesn't your mum call you Garfy?
Yep, I'm glad that's out there for sure. You've done your homework. Yeah, Garfy is what my family calls me. Gary is what the fans of the Dollop call me, so I'm looking to change it up.
Yeah.
You sound like you're cool with all of it.
Yeah. I just say yeah, a yes and.
Yeah,
whatever they say, yeah. So I'm into it.
Can you help me out? I'm in the middle, like a lot of people, end of year, I'm in the middle of like planning to go overseas, and I hate the admin.
Mm. You hate what?
The admin.
Okay.
I feel like getting ready to go overseas is worse.
Yeah.
Like it's not worth it.
It's a nightmare.
You've just come from overseas.
Yes.
How are you with the admin? Do you get through all the admin?
I hate it.
Yes.
Every part of traveling is now a nightmare.
Oh.
Yeah, like I saw the woman singing gospel on that flight before. That would be like the best case scenario domestically flying in the States now.
Right.
Yeah, it's the worst. There's fees for everything.
Yeah.
Like it's crammed. It is the worst. And international travel is now terrible as well. It's all
so horrible. How did you go up in the lead up to coming
here? I took a boat.
Wrong.
I've been on the road for 6 months.
Yeah.
It was horrible. I ate a man.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's terrible.
So what is it about Australia? You keep coming back, Gazza.
It's trending. You'll have me. Any country that likes me, I love them. So the Dollop's done well here. But then I don't know. There's just something better about, I think, maybe a broad sense of humor than maybe the U.S.
You like our animals as well, don't you?
I do. I love your animals. I can't take them back, though. I know that. They say that at the...
He could on the boat, surely.
Yeah, there were actually one of them was on the boat, yeah.
Yeah, right.
I love your animals. I love how dangerous your animals are and how pedestrian you make them seem. Like, I found out about the magpie situation that you've all just grown really comfortable with for some reason.
Sweeping.
Yeah. Well, that they're trying to take your eyes. That, to me, that's where... Yeah, that is where I draw a line with a species. And I found that out in a park during dive bombing season. And then I was like, that's crazy. And then someone was like, well, if you want to go out, you just put, like, pipe cleaners in your hat. And I was like, well, that's just not a way to live. You know, that's not okay.
Or an ice cream bucket with eyes on the front.
Yep, totally normal stuff to you. To me, sounds a little wacky. And then quokkas are my favorite.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I love quokkas. So I went to Rottnest Island, which is a gorgeous name. Yeah. And and I had an experience with a quokka where there was, like, they were all running away from me, as most do. And and this one was just sort of sitting there, and he was letting me, like, give it, like, pet him like a cat. So I was just kind of like petting him, and then I like picked him up and he nuzzled into my bosom.
Oh my God.
It was really like a life-changing moment.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, and then I go into this little cafeteria after and I say to the woman who's working there, because I was just like on another planet, I was like, I just held the quokka in my arms for like 25 minutes. And she goes, quokkas, they're riddled with disease. And I was like, what? And then I was washing my arms like I was in surgery, and that was the best time I got chlamydia.
Yeah. Might see slightly
No, I still have it.
Oh, well, I've got it now. Yeah.
Your podcast, We're Here to Help, it's a comedy advice podcast, which I love. You're sort of an agony aunt. What sort of problems do people come to you with?
It's crazy, crazy things. Stuff where you think, how did this happen? A lot of lies, lies that started as a small lie. I love that eye contact, by the way. A lot of lies.
Steve has 99 problems, but he's got one for you as well.
I've got an Airbnb house next to mine.
Congratulations.
3 a.m. Saturday morning. Mm-hmm. Some morons in there.
Oh.
You know started playing.
Yeah.
Started playing doof doof music at 3 a.m. So my solution, I just want to know whether you agree with this.
I already don't, but I want to hear it.
I went out there and fired up the whippersnipper and started doing the edges.
At what, 7 a.m. the next morning?
3 a.m.
3 a.m.?
Yeah.
Now, see, I just got to tell you, whippersnipper, the idea that you're all like, he knows what a whippersnipper is.
Yeah. You don't know what a whippersnipper
is. We call that
a weed whacker.
Brush cutter. Yeah.
A brush cutter.
Is that how you should handle a situation like this?
Go out there with a whippersnipper?
Yeah.
It seems egregious. It seems... it's tough. Does this happen a lot?
They stopped the music. No, first time.
It won't happen again. Because you got the whippersnipper.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah, if it keeps happening, what I would do is I would rent the Airbnb for a night and just trash it.
Great idea.
I'm going to rent it. I'll see you there.
Yes, need help. It's available now. To stream, would you please thank Gary Reynolds. Yeah.